But sadly for them, that's not the case, as we do have at the bottom left side from Climatology, it will be Amanda GS. And at the top side of that base, it will be Nathan GS. All right, now let's look at what these guys are doing. Oh, wait, we still have two other guys to introduce. Sushi.
Let me introduce my teammates. First, we have at the bottom right corner, Feni, the Belgium Zerg player, by the way, from Mouse Control. And then a little bit above there, we have the Dutch Protoss player, Darko Mikron.
All right, it's going to be a grudge match between Climatology and MCON, as these players are actually being mannered against each other. I did not order them to do that, but sadly, they are doing so, being very nice to each other. It will be a Zerg with Terran against a Protoss and Zerg. How do you think that your guys are going to lose this?
Well, to be honest with you, my experience with 2v2 is probably just as big as your experience with girls. I'm not really sure, but
I don't really know that much about 2v2, man.
So you just said that you have a huge insight about 2v2, so I'm really still curious on what's going to go on here.
Well, we most likely see a very entertaining game with a lot of action, because 2v2 is all about the action.
Just like with girls, see?
Yeah, and my knowledge compared to your experience with them, yeah.
Yeah, that's not as good. But we're going to see something go on here, though, because Amanda and Nathan are both moving out their SCV and drone quite early. Maybe they're going to try to annoy them with it. Maybe it's going to be some proxy buildings or something else. No, we're just going to scout with it. Very good decision by these players from Climatology. And it looks like MCON is also scouting. I don't know about that, though.
Well, scouting is just for people who don't really know what this game is about. So I guess Climatology is just like, oh, what should we do? Maybe we should scout a little bit, because we don't really know what to make. So now maybe when they scout a little bit, they know what to make. And then, yeah, of course, they're always a little bit behind if you play that way. But I guess then maybe they still have a decent chance.
What yeah. Well, I don't know about that, though. I think this drone is being really cute, just standing next to the gateway. It's like already like a mana drone. Amanda didn't forget about that drone. He just wants it to stand next to that building, I think.
I think the player from Climatology was just falling asleep a little bit.
And he was. Like mouse
totally
control,
forgetting about the drone right there.
Mouse Control is playing so bad already, he fell asleep.
Well, I'm not sure, but in my opinion, Mouse Control has a much better probe standing at the bottom or middle to high left part of the map, where Darko Mikron just hit a probe, and I don't think Climatology has any plan on scouting it for a long time.
I don't think they need to scout it, to be honest, because he's already moving it. It was like in the perfect position, but now he's kind of giving it away, of course.
No, he didn't, because it was still out of range of the building hatchery. So Darko Mikron knows that there's an expansion building, while Climatology is still in the dark.
Yep, as Climatology is building an expansion, Vini is thinking, that's a very good idea, I'll do that as well. Copying my players, of course. Does mean he's a little bit behind on doing that. We also have some Zerglings moving across the map. I love this by Amanda right now. This is really good. We also have some Zerglings moving across the map from Vini, but they will, of course, not see the Zerglings from Amanda. What do you think is going to happen here?
Yeah, this is going to go down right now, because Feni's speed is, of course, a little bit faster done than from Climatology. So he's going to be able to scout a little bit earlier due to his skill, of course. And we see Amanda GS going for a Baneling Nest, so he might go aggressive because he knows he cannot stand against Mouse Control in a long game.
Yep, it looks like Feni is coming from behind, but there's also Hellions on the field. This could be a Hellion Zergling build. Something that's very common in 2v2, actually, and of course also very powerful
in the
early
league.
Game.
Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah. It ranges, it's very good in the Bronze League, which means that they could have picked this build especially against Mouse Control.
Yeah, that is definitely true. This may be a very low-skilled match, but of course Mouse Control is just going lower to their standards, because they don't want to make your clean team look like all bad and stuff, you know, because we're mannered like that.
We do see some Banelings moving in towards the expansion, and let's see how this is gonna go. The queen is gonna be under fire first. The Banelings will take some Zerglings down and do some splash damage on the queen, barely not killing it. Vini,
of
a little bit lucky there.
The queen survives, of course, due to his great skill. He knows what damage he could take, and now the queen is totally fine. There's some more Zerglings coming, but they're all distracted by the Zerglings of Feni. I'm sure he can give them enough time. Look at this. Amanda GS doesn't really know what he's doing. He's just walking around, just wasting Zerglings after Zergling.
Yep, some Zerglings got taken out by the Mothership Core. But in the back foot of this, it does look like Nathan right now also has a starport up, barracks, factory, getting basically everything, as well as a command center. That means he's going to lift some units into the base of Vini. And Vini is currently not aware of this. And I think Nathan is gonna, you know, kick your guy out.
Well, if we look at the main base of Feni, there's something going on in a couple of moments' time. But the expansion of Amanda GS is under heavy fire and it's going to go down definitely. But at the same time, Feni has to be a little bit careful about this push right here. He doesn't really have a lot of units at home, so Dark Omicron has to help him out right here. Losing a couple of drones in the process, but of course, that's no biggie. And this drop is going to clean up quite easily.
Well, I don't know about that, actually, because it's going to be Marines against what seems to be just two Stalkers and an Immortal. He is doing some damage to it, does take down the medevac, does still take a lot of damage, though. And that drop being very effective. Now, on the other side of the map, we do indeed see that Amanda's losing his expansion, but can run all of these Zerglings into a Baneling, potentially. There should be enough units to clean that up. I would say that MCOM is slightly ahead right now with the two bases. But that's something you have to do as Climatology, because like people come to this event, they want to be entertained. So you have to make sure that your opponent is a little bit ahead, so you can crush them afterwards.
Yeah, that's a really smart choice if you want to lose the game, of course. If we look at the work account, Dark Omicron is way ahead of the other players. Actually, both mouse control players have quite a lot few more workers than their Mythology counterparts, which means that the longer mouse control waits right now, the better a situation is for them.
Yeah, they do have those expansion up, which does trouble me a little bit knowing that, to be honest. We do see right now from Nathan, he is adding a lot more barracks. He also has his command center flying towards the natural and adding siege tanks as well. Looks like he's going to go into the more tech-heavy centric units. And from your player from mouse control, from Dark Omicron, we see he's adding the robotics facility, which will add those Colossus later on. And it looks like there's a Spire coming up for Remanda. And from your Zerg player right now, no Spire as of yet. He is not mining that much gas, actually, but should be getting some sort of tech. For now, it's just Roaches, though.
Yeah, the funny thing is that your Zerg player is doing exactly the same, although his Spire, of course, is a little bit faster, but both of their tech is really late. The Spire, of course, could do a lot of damage, potentially, but since his expansion was damaged, it died, his gas income is quite low as well, which means he can only make like two or three mutas when the Spire is done.
Yep, and on the main stage, we do have, I think it's going to be Harstam against Rep, because it is getting really crowded up there, which means extra thanks to the guys that are still watching this game. As well, of course, as the guys tuning in at home. Of course, you can have two streams open there. Very nice, though, of you guys supporting these clans here. We see a third base coming up from Veni right now, which is a little bit greedy. Not of tech, like you mentioned. The production tab is going a bit crazy in this 2v2. A lot of siege tanks out from our Terran player. And it looks like the Protoss player is also trying to expand. Your clan is going all-out expansion.
Yeah, it looks like, because Climatology is not really pressuring or anything. They're just giving mouse control every room to just expand to whatever the hell they want to. Now, Amanda GS is going to scout this expansion made by Dark Omicron, which is a gold expansion, by the way. So if Mythology doesn't do anything about this, I think mouse control will have a really big economical lead, which will lead to your clan's demise.
Well, I think they're going to do something about it, or at least going to pressure one of the two expansions with some Zerglings, but Zerglings won't do that much damage there, though. A lot of probes going down effectively by these Zerglings here. The Zealots are being warped in, but still being taken down. The Photon Cannon does go down as well there, though. Aren't you afraid of a push coming? Because there are a lot of siege tanks out, there's a lot of Marines out. And, I mean, with the Mutas out as well, that could be very frightening at this point, because there's not that much to kill the Mutas or the Siege Tanks with right now.
Yeah, I guess you have a good point, but at the same time, the Siege Tank count is only at 4, which in a 1v1 game is quite good, but in a 2v2 game, I'm not so sure, since the armies are twice as big. And Feni has quite a nice Roach count of 22, which means he can tank a lot of damage. At the same time, Dark Omicron has a couple of sentries for Guardian Shield, so I think when a battle does finally happen, mouse control definitely has the small edge at the moment. But like I said earlier, their economic lead is so big right now, especially since Mythology didn't do anything about the gold base. The longer mouse control waits, the better.
The longer mouse control keeps the gold base and the other expansion, and the further ahead they will be, of course. This is true. Not that much mining going on from the Zerg yet at this turret base. I do expect that Nathan and Amanda will move out momentarily as They are moving out right now, actually. And there's not that much from your Zerg player. He is making Hydras, but they're not upgraded yet. And they are not coming out with huge numbers yet. There's 5 on the way. But the Roaches will just melt to the siege tanks, I feel like.
Yeah, and I also feel like your Terran player has so many Marines that Feyni should definitely make a Baneling list and upgrade Baneling speed so he can crush the Marines. But the creep spread across the map is so bad from both Zerg players that Banelings will not do that much. So I don't know if that will be a good decision. Maybe Infestors will be a really wise choice. Of course, that's way too late right now because Clementine is just moving out, going to kill the gold base right now. Mouse Control noticed this, gonna take the engagement, no siege tanks. Oh my god, this is gonna go really bad for Clan Mythology, I'm afraid.
Yep, Mythology moving out with the Mutas across the map. And behind that, trying to take down the expansion. Not the best choice there, actually, because...
no, they lost all of their siege tanks. The Muta count is at something like 11 or something, which is not that much. 3 Colossus and 2 Immortals for the Protoss from Mouse Control. They're just gonna take the engagement. I think they're just going to crush Clematology in this engagement.
I don't know about that. The Conclave's pretty good with the Marines. The Time Warps, however, our lucky click. Obviously, that was just a misclick that turned out really good from your player right there. But yeah, this is not looking that good for our 2v2 guys right now.
Now, it looks like Mouse Control has this game in the bag. They're just going to pressure on. They're going to kill the Zerg player right here. The Terran player is next to follow. He has like 1 siege tank in his main base, but of course that's not going to be enough. It's GG, well played. Mouse Control takes the first game.
Yeah, not a big surprise there. I mean, if Mouse Control is going to take one game, it should be the 2v2 because it's less skill-based than the 1v1 games to begin with. So
yeah, you have a really valid point right there. It's a good excuse to make up for your loss. At the same time, I must say this game was won quite convincingly.